questions or comments, criticisms?
Thanks, Peter. That's really interesting for me because our local asylum seeker support group is, you know, receives reports every couple of months from the Welcome Project, the Women's Welcome Project. So it's really good to have this kind of context and background for the way in which FareShare works. Now, I'm wondering, when we put our energies into this kind of action, which is trying to get people fed today, then those energies are not being put into the political stuff, which you hinted at. There's an agenda there that needs to be engaged with. And I'm wondering whether we need to, you can't stop feeding people today because they're hungry today. But I wonder, but the churches also and the faith groups also need to engage with the political agenda on this. And it strikes me, you know, increasingly our markets don't work for anything that we need. You know, markets are filled with food, but as you've shown, they're a long way from perfect with food. You know, we're getting growing numbers of people who can't access food through market, you know, increasing amounts of food being wasted through market. So I'm wondering if almost we need to kind of have in our heads that when we undertake some kind of practical, you know, ultimately charitable action, although I take your point entirely that the businesses see this as part of their corporate social responsibility, but when we engage in this kind of charitable action to try and do the redistribution ourselves, but at the same time we need to have a kind of strand of political activity, which is about trying to get at the bigger picture, you know, that somehow we need always to think that these things have to go hand in hand, and we have to have energies for both of the things need to be solved today. We can't wait till tomorrow to give the children food, but also we can't postpone the day that we engage with the political action.
Well, just I know from my work with the Diocese of Leicester that Leicester is joining the project that is called Feeding Britain, and that is political action. It was Frank Field who was saying what is happening around the place. And so Feeding Britain is a project where it's actually going into different places. There's projects all around the country. Leicester is about to be another of those projects. And so I've sat there representing the Diocese of Leicester, but you had the local authorities, you had the charities, you had social services, trying to get everybody in the same room together just to try and respond to those sorts of challenges and say what can be done. So
this is a lot of this is about redistributing income, isn't it? A lot of households are now too poor.
It's really important because I mean the Feeding Britain FareShare nationally has been involved in the Feeding Britain programme and is one of the partners of that, and working with Frank Field and the others. FareShare is working nationally, politically, to try and reduce the amount of food waste. It is working politically to try and challenge why there is so much poverty.
But is Feeding Britain dealing with the income distribution issues? Does it go to that sort of very fundamental level?
No.
Because I think those are the sorts of things that we need to be engaging with.
I'd like to put a different angle on this. In our Justice and Peace Group, and in my commendable Justice and Peace Groups, we have tried to get people to address poverty in Leicester and how we can get actively involved. And people shy away because they say they won't do politics. But it's also Christianity. Mm-hmm. And are there any resources from our churches that are coming into for us so that we can help our... I was shocked to see the independent Christmas charity was involved in Leicester schools because they were hungry.
Church Urban Fund are producing resources. If you go to their website, there is resource there.
Are they effective? These are Church of England churches who are not wanting to say, oh yes, so there's a reason why they're poor. It's
Well, I suppose the answer to that, speaking as an Anglican anyway, is a good old Anglican compromise, and the answer is yes and no. There are Anglican churches who are getting nowhere, probably sitting on their hands and doing nothing. There are others, and I can offer you one, which is the Church of the Martyrs in West Coast Drive in Leicester, who are getting out there and are supporting people, feeding people, and have been doing it for years. They've been there challenging the structures and systems on one hand, so doing the political work, and they have been feeding people as part of their week in, week out faithful structure. So some of them are.
With you.
Unfortunately, it's looking more to true. But he didn't say, well, just ignore them and they'll go away. He said, go and be a good neighbour to them. Well, okay, that can be quite a challenge at times. And okay, it may be a difficult structure to push. And yes, indeed, as the political climate in Derbyshire changes from, you know, one party to another, it changes how people wish to spend into public funds. Okay, we may not want to get involved in party politics, but we'll still get involved in politics, because politics is being involved with people. And people is what we're involved with as our faith calls us to. Now, I don't have answers to quite a lot of these questions. FareShare has sought to try to deal with some of this in a practical way. Appreciate it's only a sticking plaster over that wound, but at least it's better than nothing. Sorry, Kevin.
Can I ask, is there a sort of data bank that I could go to find out what are the needs in Surrey in deal by local authority? Because I feel that the only way we're going to tackle things is locally, involving our local politicians. But where do we go for the statistics of either homelessness or poverty or the amount of food that is being distributed to people like yourselves?
I think Christina can answer that for you.
Well, I know that Church Urban Fund, if you go to their website, then you can go to any individual district and you can find out the distribution of, so you can find out what is the most, I mean, certainly for Church of England, you can go down to individual parishes and you can see, you know, how deprived they are. And then Church Urban Fund, I think, then can enable people to have access funds to create things like these community cafes. But I think the thing is that often people need to work ecumenically. And for the Diocese of Leicester, I got back from every church what they were doing. About 20% of the churches were doing active outreach. They didn't always mention everything that they actually said, to be honest. But I think it's useful to do that scan in each area. And I think the Catholic Church, it's quite a big project to do, but actually knowing what's happening in your area. Certainly at the end of January, the Diocese of Leicester hosted a meeting that brought together local authority, police, charities. It was focused on how do we support the homeless, but it seemed to be an occasion when you got in the same room, people who were outside that room were criticising each other, saying, oh, well, you know, the local authority doesn't do anything, but actually, now we've got the people who walk around the streets giving the hungry food and sleeping bags and blankets, but they are also talking to the council, so, and hopefully it means that the work won't be, it needs to be more joined up, certainly, so that, because if there are well-meaning people of lots of church denominations who want to help, and sometimes I think they're an untapped resource, but sometimes they don't do it in the best way.
Yes.
In your speech, you said that in the literature, you're able to tap just a bit of literature. You don't go in any other areas of the issue.
Part of Lincolnshire gets covered from FareShare Yorkshire.
Yeah.
So they cover. But we are aware that, you know, there's a number number one, there's an awful lot of rural Lincolnshire.
Yes.
I don't, you know, there is an awful lot of need there, which is not being met. And two, some of it is just basically at the moment too far away to make it financially viable to go and deliver to. So, yeah, I'm sorry that it's not a, it's certainly not any perfect answer to the structure, but it is expanding. We, as FareShare National, we are trying to cover more of the country, but we're aware that there are holes. East Anglia, you know, you get to the east coast and it is just very difficult to cover. We've got a new depot that's just opened at Ipswich, but it still means that North Norfolk is not getting covered. Perhaps in time it will be, but
FareShare are trying to encourage people, if they can organise, say, five or six different charities in an area, if there was one drop-off point that one of the FareShares could get to, then they would drop off one and then the charities would come into one sort of central hub. So that's another development that's going on. But of course that is very dependent on whether the charities can get themselves organised, but it is a possibility that FareShare will be found.
The other thing that's happening is FareShare Go are arranging with some charities to be able to go to supermarkets and pick up surplus food direct from supermarkets. So a charity registers and is paired up, for instance, with a Tesco, that they're able to go at the end of the day and receive some food. It tends quite often to be a bakery and that sort of thing, but they just have to turn up and go and collect the food probably at sort of 8 o'clock at night. So yet again, not perfect, but better than nothing.
Yeah. And presumably that's not being recorded, how much of that?
Oh yes, yes, it's all recorded.
So who records it?
The supermarket record what food is given to the charity, and FareShare Go record the charity details and the collections.
Right, so you will know that Tesco's in Guildford gives to various charities in Guildford.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, I mean those figures will be recorded on our online management system. Probably not the individual foods. It will depend on how Tesco recorded it. If Tesco recorded that 200 kilos of bakery have gone out, then that would be what we'd have. Whereas when it comes into us, you know, and it's Tesco shows by 400 gram pack, so all of that is recorded and captured. It's as much as they need to send that food out. I know it can seem difficult, and it can seem that perhaps, you know, you're just working one person trying to encourage your churches to do something, or one person trying to do something in your parish. Just think, there are some one persons who've made significant changes. Things can happen just from one person, and they can make significant never changed.
Affiliate with you,
and
is there a way that people can show support for you, or is it just
by
donations?
Some churches are affiliated to us in as much as they are a community member. In other words, if it's a church that is providing food or services to people, then some of them are our community members. But we operate as an independent charity. We were set up by the Diocese of Leicester, FareShare East Midlands, but we are a completely independent charity. We have a faith background, but we make no requirements on those receiving our services to have any faith. And we support all people, whoever. We don't actually have a support group in as much as that. We occasionally get harvest contributions from churches and so on who'd like to support that. And we were always very happy to take financial support, because as I said earlier, it's a darn expensive operation to run, and we would like to be able to carry on supporting it. But in that way, we don't actually have a sort of support network.